Hello dear student, welcome to the video lecture series. Today we will discuss the heavy metal poisoning as per the syllabus set by Swami Ramanand Tirth Marathwada University for 4th year B Pharmacy at semester subject clinical pharmacy and drug interactions. Subject code is BPH 87. Myself Dr. J.P. Lahande, Associate Professor, Department of Pharmaceutics, Shulingeshwar College of Pharmacy, Almala, Taluka Osa, District Latur. Heavy metal poisoning, this topic we have to cover in following subtopics. What does the heavy metal poisoning means? What are the symptoms associated with heavy metal poisoning? That to be very specific, metal symptoms and some of the general symptoms. As far as the metal specific symptoms are concerned, mercury poisoning symptoms, lead poisoning symptoms, arsenic poisoning symptoms and cadmium poisoning symptoms. Then we have to see what causes the heavy metal poisoning, like arsenic, cadmium, lead and mercury. What do I know, what do one should know if one have metal poisoning? Then what is the treatment associated with the poisoning cases? All these are the topics that are associated with in the couple of slides. So heavy metal are the elements that are naturally found in the earth. They are used in many modern day applications such as agriculture, medicine and industry. Your body eventually contains some heavy metals, zinc, iron and copper, for example. These are necessary for regular body function as long as they aren't present in toxic amount. So only in toxic amount these are responsible for producing the poisoning cases. Heavy metal poisoning occur when your body's soft tissues absorb too much of a particular metal. The most common metals that the human body can absorb in toxic amounts are mercury, lead, cadmium and arsenic. You might be exposed to high concentrations of these metals from air, food, water, pollution, as well as medicine, food containers with improper coatings, industrial exposure or lead based paint. In the United States, heavy metal poisoning is very rare. It only occurs when you have been exposed to a significant amount of heavy metal, usually over a long period of time. But the popularity of over-the-counter products that claim to detoxify your body of heavy metals can make it seem more common than it is. What are the symptoms of heavy metal poisoning? The symptoms of heavy metal poisoning vary depending on the nature and type of metal that is involved. Some of the general symptoms associated with these are: common symptoms across several types of heavy metal poisoning include diarrhea, nausea, abdominal pain, vomiting, shortness of breath, tingling in your hands and feet, chills and weaknesses. Children with heavy metal poisoning may have usually firm or weakened bones. Pregnant people also have a miscarriage or they deliver prematurely. To be very specific, we have to see some of these symptoms. Certain types of heavy metal poisoning can cause additional symptoms. Here is a look at the symptoms linked to some of the most common types. Mercury poisoning symptoms. It causes lack of coordination, muscle weakness, hearing and speech difficulties, nerve damage in your hands and face, vision changes, trouble walking. The symptoms associated with lead poisoning include constipation, aggressive behavior, sleep problems, irritability, high blood pressure, loss of appetite, anemia, headache, fatigue, memory loss and loss of developmental skills in case of children. Arsenic poisoning causes nausea, vomiting and diarrhea, red or swollen skin, spots on your skin such as warts or lesions, unusual heart rhythms and muscle cramps. The cadmium poisoning causes fever, breathing problems, and muscle pains. Now, what causes heavy metal poisoning? Heavy metals can enter your body in different ways. You might consume them in the food you eat or absorb them through your skin. For example, here is how you might be exposed to various heavy metals. Keep in mind that heavy metal poisoning occurs with heavy or frequent exposure, usually over a long period of time. Occasional exposure won't lead to heavy metal poisoning. What causes heavy metal poisoning? In that we will see arsenic. Arsenic that is due to working near a hazardous work site, living in an area that has high levels in rocks, water and soil, ingesting insecticides, pesticides or herbicides, eating contaminated seafood or algae, drinking contaminated water. All these will cause the heavy metal poisoning associated with arsenic. As far as cadmium heavy metal poisoning is concerned, that will occur due to working in an industrial setting, especially one where ore is processed or smelted, welding on alloys that contain cadmium, or using silver solders, inhaling cigarette smoke. All these are responsible for cadmium poisoning. For lead poisoning, particularly living in a home with high levels of lead-based paint, doing industrial construction work, radiator repair or smelter operation, being in firing range, using coal cosmetics, applying progressive hair dyes, though the FDA is working to change this, using foreign digestive remedies like cadmium product, kohl, surma, kajal or progressive hair dyes. The reason behind mercury poisoning is mining producing or transporting mercury, mining and refining gold, silver ores, consuming contaminated fish or water, manufacturing mirrors, x-ray machines, incandescent lamps, lights or vacuum pumps. How do one should come to know if one have heavy metal poisoning? The doctors can usually check for heavy metal poisoning with a simple blood test known as heavy metal panel or heavy metal toxicity test. To do the test, they will take a small blood sample and test it for signs of heavy metals. If you have symptoms of heavy metal poisoning but your blood test only shows low levels, your doctor might do some additional testing, and these may include kidney function test, liver function studies, urine analysis, hair analysis, fingernail analysis, electrocardiograms and x-rays. Once the heavy metal poisoning will occur, it must be treated. So for mild cases of heavy metal poisoning, just eliminating your exposure to heavy metals can be enough to treat the condition. Depending on the underlying cause, this might mean taking some time away from work or changing your diet. Your doctor can give you more specific recommendations on how to reduce your exposure. For more severe cases, the standard treatment is chelation therapy. This involves giving an indication either through a pill or injection that binds to the heavy metals in your body. These medications are known as chelators. As they bind to the metal, chelators help to usher them out of your body as a waste.